German intelligence needs a job to be done. There's a German law, we'll let it do.
Our unit was set up to develop resources.
We're not policemen.
We're spies.
Marissa and I recently got a chance to check out a movie called A Most Wanted Man. It stars the late Philip Seymour Hoffman. Rachel McAdams is in there. Willem Dafoe is in this.
Crazy.
It's a good cast. Robin Wright is in this.
She's
terrific. The movie is an espionage thriller, and it's directed by Anton Corbijn, who most recently brought us The American, starring George Clooney. And he is doing some very enjoyable work as a director. He's a meticulous craftsman when it comes to setting up shots.
Yep.
He is a photographer that changed his life direction and became a film director later on in life. And it really shows in his movies. And I think the story and the material is terrific. It's based on a Jean Le Carré novel that's been updated, obviously, for more modern times. But I think the stylistic overtones that Corbijn paints with his images really helps to make this movie memorable.
Our sources don't come to us.
Hi, Oliver. Good to see you.
We find them.
This movie is quite an experience to sit through. I really wasn't expecting this kind of movie when I sat down, because all these spy espionage type movies that we've seen, especially as of late, have been so thriller driven.
Yeah,
just so exciting.
Right?
Yeah, post-Bourne, exactly. Mm-hmm. This is what real life is like. And I feel like it also reflects on what society is telling us as well in the world. This movie is incredibly topical, considering they filmed it quite a while ago, not only with the themes in here, but also with Philip Seymour Hoffman's character and some of the conversations that he's having, especially with Robin Wright. I felt like that was really eerie almost.
Yeah, Philip Seymour Hoffman is a man that is completely unraveling through the course of the film. He's a guy that's been just destroyed and beaten up by his constant efforts to do the right thing in a world that is constantly surveilling and trying to profile every one of us as human citizens, and particularly those in the Muslim faith who have to contend with and deal with this all the time.
Well, right, this is a post 9/11 world, and they're just trying to clean up all of the things. They don't want another 9/11 to happen, which is fair.
Mm-hmm.
It's understandable. So I feel like they're really cracking down on people that may or may not be involved in something sinister. I love that this movie and the director and the people involved just respect us as audience members, because we're sitting there taking it all in, and they're allowing us to think and be present and be a part of this.
Yeah, it's also incredibly ambiguous, and Philip Seymour Hoffman's trying to be tactful, and this is very analogous to what we're seeing with Snowden and NSA surveillance.
I've been observed by Americans before. It usually doesn't end well.
There's kind of a sledgehammer approach and a sweeping gesture approach with the way that all of these spy agencies around the world are all racing to get the notches on the belt.
It's so true. But what you need to do when you're trying to get the squirrel is get them to come over and show them the nut. You're trying to get them to come over. You're not trying to make any big motions because the squirrel will run away. And that's kind of what everyone around Philip Seymour Hoffman is doing, and they're trying to take away from him, is a squirrel that he's trying to bring over. And it's crazy to watch and see go down. And it's also, I mean, the movie doesn't leave you feeling happy when you walk out of this
thing. Well, it's because it's an enormous industry, and I think that there's just so much theater and so much manufactured kind of business around all of this stuff, and this is the type of thing
that you think about when you walk out.
Yeah. We have turned the spying and the surveillance on regular citizens into a really big industry, and these people's budgets are approved based on arrests that are made and people that are sitting in prisons around the world, and it's horrifying, and that's the bleakness that is presented. I don't think this would be as satisfying if it didn't have the intelligence, again, no pun intended, of the performers, because they're all so terrific.
Oh my God, I can't say enough good things about it. I feel like it's not going to attract a lot of attention, though, in the theaters, because it's not these shiny blockbusters that we've been seeing so far this summer, which is unfortunate, because I feel like this is definitely the contrast to Michael Bay's atrocity that we just saw.
It's the opposite of the Transformers.
Exactly.
Yeah, and it does feel a little bit weird and incongruous in the summer months, but I think if you see it, you won't forget it, and you'll be haunted by Philip Seymour Hoffman, who once again reminds us how fragile life is and what a powerful talent he was.
You have 72 hours to bring this matter to resolution.
I'm going to give A Most Wanted Man a 9 out of 10.
It gets an 8.5 for me.